I'd like to welcome everyone today to the memorial service for Floyd Winfield Williams and his wife, Mary Bass Williams. It's not every day that we have an opportunity to recognize a fellow veteran and his wife who have both contributed to the American Legion in the community, the district, and the Commonwealth of Virginia. The American Legion was chartered by Congress in 1919 as a patriotic, mutual health and community service organization. It has a worldwide membership of 2.8 million. The Department of Virginia is divided into 222 local posts, and those posts have a total of 59,000 members. Our local post, 245 here in Galax, has a membership of 174. Later you'll hear about Williams' contributions and his wife, Mary. They've supported veterans and the American Legion for most of their adult lives. In 2003, when the local American Legion post was reorganized as Post 245, the last remaining trustee of the original post, 145, recommended that the new post should be named in honor of Floyd Winfield Williams. It reported that Floyd always carried a membership application with him, and everyone who was eligible, he asked them to join. Today, we will honor their past services and mark their graves with a special reminder of what they mean to our organization. At this time, our chaplain will provide the opening prayer.
Let us pray. Our Father, we ask your blessing. Gather here to honor those veterans who've gone before us and those that are still here with us this day. Grant that what we do here today will be pleasing in your sight as we offer homage for all of them. And be with us as we continue this day's service. These and all other blessings we ask. Amen.
Bio of Floyd Winfield Williams. American Legion Post number 245 was chartered July 17, 2003 and was named in memory of Floyd Winfield Williams. Floyd Williams was born December 12, 1892. Upon completion of his education, he taught in the public schools of Carroll County for a few years. Floyd registered for the military draft for World War I. His registration card shows that he is a natural born citizen of Woodlawn, Virginia. He enlisted in the Medical Corps, Division I in Atlanta, Georgia on July 6, 1918, where he served with honor until receiving his discharge on January 10, 1919. He served from July 27, 1918, and later attended non-commissioned officer school at Camp Greenleaf, Georgia. Floyd was promoted to sergeant on September 5th, 1918. Upon his return to civilian life, he operated a dry cleaning business in Galax on Grayson Street. As a World War I veteran, Floyd was an active charter member of American Legion Blue Ridge Post number 145 in Galax. He was first elected post commander in 1932-33 and served four consecutive years. He was vice commander of the 9th District from 1934-35 and commander of the 9th District from 35-36. The district enjoyed exceptional years under his leadership. From 1940-1942, he served as post adjutant. He was always interested in the youth, and he organized the Boys Drum and Bugle Corps of the Blue Ridge Post. He served as American Legion Department Commander from 1942-1943. The Legion was working under handicaps, for the nation was still at war, and there were travel restrictions which limited the department and district officers. A number of the Legion programs were mostly suspended during the war years. Floyd Williams' term as department commander was extremely rewarding. when we realized the limited resources that they had to work with. They accomplished much in support of the war effort, our armed services overseas, and programs to assist veterans when they returned home. In the late 1940s and early 1950s, Floyd was elected as a delegate to the Virginia State Legislature. In October 1949, he went to Roanoke to hear President Roosevelt and was given a reserved seat on the speaker's stand. Mrs. Floyd Williams was elected department president of the American Legion Auxiliary in August of 1950. In 1951, Mrs. Williams served as president of Borough State Committee in Roanoke. And as we know, Floyd Williams and his wife, Mary, are buried here at this site in Felt Cemetery.
We will now observe a moment of silence for our prayer. Father, again we humbly come into your presence, asking that you would look upon us with favor as we offer our thanks for all the blessings that you have given us. We ask that you remember all the members of the American Legion, past and present, as they gather to offer a special tribute to the ones who gave so much to their country and the American Legion. Father, we are so very thankful for all those who served and now serve our country, both at home and abroad, to support our great nation, Father, Father, bless the memory of Mr. Floyd Williams and Mary Vance Williams, to whom we pay tribute for all that they did for the nation, the American Legion, and the Ladies Auxiliary. May we never forget. Amen.
At this time, we'll have the placing of the bronze markers on the graves.
Ceremony this afternoon.